Mr. Redwin. Well, when you get back to New York, you'll get some more of that doggone cold weather. Don't worry about that. Hey, Edwin, when you get back to New York, you're going to get plenty of that cold weather there, Roger.
Roger, well, I'm Roger from Brooklyn. Anyway, you're in New York, and if you live in Brooklyn, no matter where in the world you go, you always go back. That's the county to be in. So I don't know what to tell you, but I do. Over here it's not bad, because...
over there, it's not bad. I don't know, I think I'd rather have, man, if it could be like 75 degrees all year round, man, that would be perfect for me there. Go ahead.
No, well, no, 75 degrees. Sometimes now during the winter, it will get about 60.
Hey, Roger on that, man. Man, you're really coming in here good, Edwin. I'm going to tell you what, man. You're like 7 by 30. You're like 7 by 30, man. You're just tearing up my radio. What the heck are you working with over there? Go ahead.
Roger, listen to you. Out of all the stations that I'm hearing, including the New York guys, you're the strongest. You are the strongest. We're using the Kenwood 430. We just had a rebuild. And the antenna is the Astro 99, which we're making some experiment with it to see if we could improve the antenna itself.
All right, you're on that. Yeah, that's a good deal. Antro 99, man. Well, you must have something pretty special in line, man, to be hitting me like that. So, I don't know what kind of experiment you're doing over there, but I'm going to guess to say you might have that thing leaning over a little bit at like a 45-degree angle or got it on the horizontal side because, I mean, it's coming in here real nice, really nice there, Roger.
No, well, today is bad because it's not only hot, it's 100% humidity, so you know that is no good. But like I told you before, during November, December, January, the temperature goes down to 60, 70. Beautiful. T-shirt weather.
You're right, you're on that, man. Don't go it. That's a heck of a deal right there. Yeah, I'm working on talking on my own creation pretty much. I mean, full wave delta loop, shaped in four diamonds there, direct fed, 61 foot off the ground. And just letting her do all she can. And I'll tell you what, I went to see what you sounded like vertical versus horizontal. And man, I'll tell you what, you're doing a fantastic job both ways. Good Lord, in a quarter, man. What kind of experiment you doing with that AMTRON 99 over there?
We tried to make I remember the old Astro plane, so we added some wires. Maybe when I'm finished, I'll probably take some photos and put it in on the media so people could copy it, because to see if they work as good as this one. So everybody could enjoy it, a cheap antenna with nice work with them.
So you took an Astro, you took an Antron 99, and you converted it over to look like a Astro plane. Now see, looks like. And that's wow. That's pretty doggone cool, dude. So I take it you mounted something up there. I would guess to say right where the center piece of the antenna. You must have put like some kind of bracket across right there, and you ran two copper wires down to some kind of loop connection that mounts at the bottom of the antenna there. Go ahead.
Roger, I think you know what you might do. I think you're seeing the antenna, because that's exactly what I did. We have four horizontal radiation, and we took from, not from the tip, from the second tip of the antenna, we unplugged it and we put a washer, and then from the, we made holes in the washer and brought copper wire number 12, because that's what I did use before. We used the copper wire number 12, and receiving, she's beautiful. And I'm, like I said, I'm testing to see how it works. On SWR right now, we also reflecting between 1.2 and 1.4. So we have it exactly where we like it, because reflecting zero, what people do is close the frequency. We want to reflect a little. The frequency, this way we keep it open and see if you will smell it yourself.
Hey, Roger D on that, man. Well, I'll tell you what. I was just listening to you with my my vertical antenna, okay? And I heard you with no problem whatsoever. But I'll tell you what, you got that Doug Plunkett transmitting definitely more on the horizontal side. That is awesome, dude. I mean, that is awesome. That is one, see, that's what I do too. Hey, brother, that's what I do as well. I love playing with antennas. I mean, you know, it's pretty obvious. I made the one that I'm using as well from scratch. But, man, that Doug Plunkett is working real good. What's your call numbers out there? You got a set of call numbers, don't you?
Roger, this is the 519 Edward in Puerto Rico. And like I said, all the time, we've been making adjustments to the antennas, because when I was in New York, I was using the Wilson 6 element, and we added a few things that made it work a lot easier, especially when you live in an apartment building that you don't want to leave no radiation, or you don't want to have people coming complaining to you that they cannot listen to the radio or watching television. So we did a lot of things, and we keep the same habit. We buy an antenna and we look at it, we use it, and then we start working with it yourself.